Dear students, welcome. This is our 13th class on statics. First of all, I shall try to solve these two problems. Question number 16, today's question number 1. 3-4 says, PQR at the incenter I of a triangle ABC in the direction IA, IB, IC respectively. Prove that if the forces are in equilibrium, then we have to prove this one. Perhaps you remember such type of questions has already been done earlier. Let me write like this. ABC is a triangle. ABC is a triangle. ABC is a triangle. I is the incenter of the triangle. The center of this triangle, of the circle is the incenter of the triangle ABC. Now join IA, IB and IC. Join IA, IB and IC. The forces PQR are acting along IA, IB and IC. PQR are acting along IA, IB and IC and are in equilibrium. I is the incenter of the triangle ABC. The forces PQR are acting along IA, IB and IC. Since the forces PQR acting at I along IAIBIC IAIBIC respectively and are in equilibrium, and are in equilibrium, therefore by Lange's theorem we get P divided by sine BIC, sine of the angle BIC. This is equal to Q divided by sine CIA. This is equal to R divided by sine AIB. If three forces acting at a point are in equilibrium, then by Lange's theorem, the magnitude of each force is proportional to the sine of the angle between the other. This theorem has been applied here. Now you see, from geometry, angle IBC, this angle, this is equal to angle ABC, half of angle ABC, half of angle ABC, which can be written as half of angle B, half of B. Similarly, ICB, this is also C by 2. This is B, half of B means B by 2 or half of B. Now consider the triangle BIC. From triangle BIC, from triangle BIC, BIC plus IBC plus ICA, this is equal to 180 degrees. This is equal to 180 BIC. This means BIC equal to, it is B by 2 plus C by 2. This can be written as B plus C divided by 2. No. BIC plus B b by 2 plus c by 2 equal to 180 degree. This is equal to 180 degree. This means BIC equal to 180 degree minus b plus c divided by 2. This is equal to 180 degree minus in any triangle minus 2. You may write like this. You may write like this. A plus b plus c minus a. This is equal to 180 degree minus 180 degree minus a divided by 2. Minus a divided by 2. This is equal to 180 degree minus 90 degree minus a by 2. This is equal to 180 degree minus 90 degree plus a by 2. This is equal to 90 degree plus a by 2. 90 degree plus a by 2. BIC equal to 90 degree plus a by 2. Similarly, BIC, this is equal to 90 degree plus a by 2. Similarly, CIA will be equal to 90 degree plus b by 2. And AIB equal to 90 degree plus c by 2. 90 degree plus c by 2. 90 degree plus c by 2. Therefore, suppose this is number star. Therefore, from star, let me tell you. Therefore, from star we get. Therefore, star implies p divided by sine 90 degree plus a by 2 equal to q divided by sine 90 degree plus b by 2. This is equal to r divided by sine 90 degree plus c by 2. 90 degree plus c by 2. This means that p by cos a by 2 equal to q by cos b by 2. This is equal to r by cos c by 2. You will get this. Cos c by 2. Or p square divided by cos square a by 2 equal to q square divided by cos square b by 2 equal to r square divided by cos square c by 2. You will get this. Or multiply by 2. Cos square root multiply by 2 in denominator. Now, perhaps you have written this. This means p square by 1 plus cos a from trigonometry. 1 plus cos a equal to twice cos square a by 2. 1 minus cos a equal to twice sin square a by 2. This is equal to q square by 1 plus cos b by cos b. This is equal to r square by 1 plus cos c. 1 plus cos c. This means p square by 1 plus from trigonometry in any triangle ABC cos a can be written as b square plus c square minus a square divided by twice bc. This is equal to q square by 1 plus c square plus a square minus b square divided by twice ca. This is equal to r square divided by 1 plus a square plus b square minus c square divided by twice ab. Divided by twice ab. Twice ab. This means p square by twice bc, it will be twice bc plus b square plus c square minus a square equal to q square divided by twice ca plus c square plus a square minus b square divided by twice ca, which is equal to r square divided by twice ab plus a square plus b square minus c square divided by twice ab. Divided by twice ab. Now, this means twice BC means ABC, you may write ABC. We have twice BC will be, will go to the numerator, twice BC B square. We have written, we have multiplied by A in the numerator and also A in the numerator. Now, B square plus C square plus twice BC means B plus C whole square. Minus square, similarly, this is P square. Here, twice CA, ABC, Q square divided by B into C square plus C square plus twice CA, C plus A whole square, C plus A whole square minus B square. This is equal to twice ABC here into R square divided by A plus B whole square minus C square. A plus B whole square minus C square. This means twice ABC will be cancelled. B square divided by A into A square minus B square means A plus B into A minus B. This is equal to Q square divided by B C plus A plus B into C plus A minus B minus B, which is equal to R square by here twice ABC, we should multiply it by C. C into A plus B plus C into A plus B minus C. A plus B minus C. A plus B minus C. Now, A plus B plus C will be cancelled from all sides. B square divided by A into B plus C minus A. This is equal to Q square divided by B into C plus A minus B equal to R square divided by C into A plus B minus C. This means that this means P square is to Q square is to R square should be equal to A into B plus C minus A is to B into C plus A minus B is to C into A plus B minus C. A plus B minus C. We have proved this one. Today's question number 1. As a whole, the question number 16 has been solved. Now, this problem, question number 16 has been solved. It has been solved. I'm going to try to solve the question number 17. What is it? A and B are two fixed points in a horizontal line at a distance C apart. Two light chords AC and BC of length B and A respectively support a wave at C, so that tensions in the strings are in the ratio design. Let me try to solve this problem. Question number 17. A and B are two fixed points in a horizontal line. This is a horizontal line. A and B are two fixed points in a horizontal line. At the distance C apart, the distance between A and B is C. Two light chords AC and BC of length B and A respectively. This is a point C respectively. Support a weight C. Weight at C. Suppose there is a weight W at C. So that the tensions in the strings are in the ratio D. Suppose tensions of the strings T1 and T2. Let me write. A and B are two points. A and B are two points in the same horizontal line. In the same horizontal line. in the same horizontal line. Such that horizontal line where AB equal to C, where is B equal to C? To like chords AC and CB of lengths BN. BN irrespective, the supportive weight. This is small c, this is small c. Let T1 and T2, T1 and T2 be the tensions, be the tensions of the strings, tensions of CA and CB respectively. What C and CB respectively? This is a vertical line. Suppose this is a vertical line. We draw a Draw a vertical line through C. To meet the horizontal line AB. With the horizontal line AB. It is vertical, it is horizontal. Consequently, this angle will be equal to 90 degree and this angle will be equal to 90 degree. This is angle B. Therefore, this angle will be equal to 90 degree minus B by 2. This is 90 degree, it will be 90 degree minus B by 2. This is 90 degree, this is A. And therefore, this angle will be equal to 90 degree minus A by 2. 90 degree minus A by 2. Now, the forces. Now, the weight W. Weight W at C is balanced by the tensions T1 and T2. By the tensions T1 and T2. This means that T1, T2 and W acting at C are in equilibrium. This means that the forces T1, T2 and W acting at C are in equilibrium. Therefore, by Lami's theorem we get. T1 divided by this angle. T1 divided by this angle. What will be this angle? T1 divided by. What is this angle? 180 degree minus this angle. 180 degree minus. It is not B by 2, it is B. Not B by 2, it is B. It is A. It is B. It is 90 degree. It will be 90 degree minus B. It is 90 degree, it is A. This angle is A in the angle. Therefore, it is 90 degree minus A. It is 90 degree minus B. It is 90 degree minus A. Therefore, it will be 90 degree minus B. This is equal to by Lami's theorem T2 divided by. T2 divided by sine of angle dish. What is this? 90 degree minus. The sine. Sine 180 degree minus 90 degree minus eight. It will be like this. 180 degree minus 90 degree minus eight. This is equal to W divided by this angle. W divided by this angle. So we will not write that one. Because we have to find the ratio between T1 and T2. This means T1 divided by sine 90 degree plus B. This is equal to T2 divided by sine 90 degree plus A. 90 degree plus A. This means T1 by cos B equal to T2 by cos A. T2 by cos A. This means T1 by T2 equal to cos B by cos A. Cos B by cos A. It will be cos B by cos A. This means T1 by T2 equal to what is cos B? C square plus A square minus B square divided by twice CA. It will be B square plus C square minus A square divided by twice BC. It will be like this. Now, this is equal to twice BC into C square plus A square minus B square. It will be twice CA B square plus C square minus A square. Minus A square. Now, these two will be cancelled. CC will be cancelled. It will be B into C square plus A square minus B square divided by A into B square plus C square minus A square into this. This means that T1 is to T2, T1 is to T2 will be equal to B into C square plus A square minus B square is to A into B square plus C square minus A square. A into B square plus. Therefore, the ratios of the tensions of the strings will be in the ratio. Will be B into C square plus A square minus B square is to this one. Today I am going to solve some two more problems. First, let me remove this. I have written another two problems here. Question number 18 and question number 19. Today, this will be question number 3 and 4 respectively. What is question number 18? You see, a weight is supported on a smooth plane inclined at an angle alpha to the horizon by a string inclined to the vertical at an angle beta. Let me write, this is horizon. Suppose OA is a plane inclined to the horizon at an angle alpha. At an angle alpha. Suppose BC, no, this is BC. It is C, it is B. Suppose BC be a string inclined to the particle. Suppose this is a particle line. It is a particle line. Inclined to the particle at an angle beta. At an angle beta. Now, it is draw a line perpendicular to OA. It is a line perpendicular to OA. It is alpha. This angle will be 90 degree minus alpha. This angle will be 90 degree minus alpha. Consequently, this angle will be alpha. And this angle will be equal to again alpha. Now see,
slope of the plane is increased by, this is the second part, see the first part, a weight W, this is a weight W is at the point B, BC is the string, suppose the tension of the string BT, tension of the string BT, let me write, let OA be the plane inclined to the horizon, plane inclined to the horizon, at an angle, inclined to the horizon at an angle, alpha. Let BC be a string, whose inclination to the vertical is beta, whose inclination to the vertical is beta, whose inclination to the vertical is beta. Let T be the tension of the string B. Let T be the tension of the string BC. Tension of the string BC. W is the weight at the point B. W is the weight. Weight of a body, you may write body, FB, acting vertically downwards. Acting vertically downwards. Now, resolving the forces along the inclined plane. Now, resolving the forces. Along the inclined plane OA, we get resolving the process along the inclined plane OA, we get what is the process? W and T along the inclined. You see, the contribution of W along OA in this direction, W is acting in this direction. It is 90 degree minus alpha. Suppose if you draw a line this, so that this angle is 90 degree, this divided by W will be equal to, this angle will be equal to theta at the time. This divided by W equal to sine alpha. Therefore, it will be W sine alpha should be equal to the contribution of T along the direction OA, it will be W sine alpha. Contribution of T along OA means, suppose this is 90 degree. This is 90 degree. What will be this angle? This angle will be 90 degree minus alpha plus beta. Therefore, contribution of T along this direction will be T sine 90 degree minus alpha plus beta. Alpha plus beta. 90 degree minus alpha plus beta. This means W sine alpha equal to T, it will be, no, I am sorry, it will be not sine, it is cos. It will be cos because base by hypotenuse equal to base by hypotenuse equal to cos theta, cos 90 degree minus alpha plus beta. Therefore, it will be sine alpha plus beta. It will be sine alpha plus beta. Let me write number one. Now, see the second part. If the slope of the plane is increased to gamma, This means that slope of the originally the angle made by the plane OA to the with the horizon was alpha. This time it will be gamma. Gamma. If alpha is changed to gamma, the tension of the string is double and T is changed to twice T. T is changed to twice T. The string is double to support the weight. Then from that, then from one we get, W sine. In place of alpha, you write gamma. In place of T, you write twice T. It will be gamma plus beta. This is number two. Suppose this is number two. Now, dividing 1 by 2 we get. Dividing 1 by 2. 2 we get. Dividing 1 by 2 we get. W sin alpha by W sin gamma. Alpha by W sin gamma. This is equal to T sin alpha plus beta. Beta by twice T sin gamma plus beta means beta plus gamma. You may write like this. Beta plus gamma. This means sin alpha plus beta divided by sin alpha should be equal to sin 2 times of sin beta plus gamma divided by sin gamma. Divided by sin gamma. Now you write. This means that sin alpha plus beta means sin alpha cos beta plus cos alpha sin beta divided by sin alpha. This is equal to 2 times of sin beta cos gamma plus cos beta sin gamma divided by sin gamma. Now multiply both sides in the denominator by sin beta. Multiply. After this, you may multiply both sides of the denominator by sin beta. Here sin beta, sin beta. Then this means that this divided by this, sin alpha will be cancelled. Cos beta by sin beta will be equal to cot beta. Plus sin beta will be cancelled. Cos alpha by sin alpha, it will be cot alpha. Equal to 2 times of this divided by this. Sin beta will be cancelled. Cos gamma by sin gamma, cot gamma. Plus again 2 times of sin gamma by sin gamma cancelled. Cos beta by sin beta, cot beta. This means cos alpha, if you take this to the left hand side, it will be cot beta. This is equal to twice cot gamma. This is equal to twice cot gamma. It will be equal to twice cot gamma. Therefore, we have solved the question number 18 also. We have solved question number 18 also. It has been solved. Perhaps you have understood this one. Now, I am going to solve the question number 19. Today's question number 19. Let me try to solve the question number 19. Now,
question number 19. What is this? E and F are the midpoints of the diagonals AC and it will be BD. It will be BD of a quadrilateral ABCD. Let me first write the quadrilateral, draw the quadrilateral ABCD. Suppose this is a quadrilateral. ABCD is a quadrilateral. Is a quadrilateral. AC and BD are diagonals. AC is a diagonal and BD is also a diagonal of the quadrilateral ABC. Z is the midpoint of EF. Also E and F are the midpoints of the diagonals AC and BD. AC E is the midpoint of the diagonal AC. F is the midpoint of the diagonal BD. This is suppose F, BD. We join EF. EF. Also, Z is the midpoint of EF. Z is the midpoint of EF. We have to show that ZA plus ZB plus Z. ZA, just join ZA. ZB. And ZC. And ZB is F. ZB. ZB. Now, AC and BD are the diagonals, are the diagonals of the quadrilateral. Diagonals of the quadrilateral ABCD. E and F, E and F are the midpoints of, middle points, midpoints of the diagonals AC and BD. AC and BD respectively. Respectively. Z is the midpoint of EF. We join EF. Now Z is the midpoint of EF. Now Z is the midpoint of Z is the midpoint of EF. We join ZA, ZB, ZC, ZA, ZB, ZC, and ZB. Now, ZA plus ZB plus ZC plus ZB. This ZA, what is ZA? ZA. ZA will be equal to ZE plus EF. EA. Z from the triangle AZE. You see the triangle AZE. ZA will be equal to ZE plus EA. ZE plus EA. ZA will be equal to ZE plus EA plus ZB. You see ZB, what is ZB? Will be equal to ZB will be equal to ZF plus FB. ZF plus FB from triangle. From triangle BGF. Now ZC, what is ZC? ZC, it is ZC. Oof. This is GC. GC. This GC will be equal to ZE plus EC. ZE plus EC.
ZE plus EC. Also, last ZD, ZD will be equal to ZF plus FD. ZF plus FD. ZF plus FD. This will be like this. EE. EE. This is equal to ZE can be written as, what is ZE? ZE can be written as half of FE, half of FE plus EA. EA can be written as half of CE. See that diagram? EA can be written as half of CE. Plus, ZF can be written as half of EE, half of EF, plus FB, what is this? Plus FB, FB, DB, half of DB. Because E and F are midpoints of AC and BD respectively. Plus ZE, ZE can be written as half of FE. EC can be written as half of AC. Half of AC. Plus ZF can be written as half of EF. Plus FD. FD can be written as half of BD. Half of BD. Half is common from all the terms. You may take half common from all the terms. This is equal to half. Half. You may write here FE plus CE plus EF plus DB plus FE plus AC plus EF plus BB. BB. This is equal to half of FE. FE, it is nothing but minus EF. You may write minus EF. CA, you write minus AC. It is plus EF. DB equal to minus BB. FE means minus EF. AC means AC. EF means EF. BD means BD. You may write like this. You may write like this. Perhaps you have understood this one. Now, see, this term EF minus EF plus EF will be cancelled. Minus AC plus AC will be cancelled. Minus BD plus BD will be also cancelled. Plus EF and minus EF will be cancelled. This is equal to zero. Half into zero. Therefore, this is equal to zero. We have proved the question number 19 also. Dear students, perhaps you have enjoyed the class. Do practice. And we have done so far 19 problems. Today, I want to stop here. Thanks for attending the class. Thank you very much. Thank you.